The second model is called the hosted model. In this model, at the lowest level, there is a full-fledged host operating system that manages all of the hardware resources. The host OS integrates a virtual machine monitor module that's responsible for providing the virtual machines with their virtual platform interface and for managing all of the context switches, scheduling, etc. As necessary, this VMM module will invoke drivers or other components of the host operating system as needed. This one benefit of this model is that it can leverage all of the services and mechanisms that are already developed for the host operating system. Much less functionality needs to be redeveloped for the VMM module in this manner. Also note that on this host operating system, you may run guest VMs through the virtual machine module, but you can also run native applications directly on the host operating system as you would in general. One example of the hosted model is KVM, which stands for kernel-based VM, that's based on the Linux operating system. The Linux host provides all aspects of the physical hardware management, and just like any regular OS, it can run directly regular Linux applications. The support for running guest virtual machines is through a combination of a kernel module, that's the KVM module, and a hardware emulator called QEMU. We said that the goal of virtualization is to provide identical hardware, so here this emulator is used as virtualizer, so it really matches the underlying hardware resources, the x86, Intel, or AMD. The support for running guest VMs in KVM is through a combination of a kernel module KVM and a hardware emulator QEMU. And we said that virtualization, the intent is to provide identical hardware, so this QEMU emulator isn't emulating some bizarre hardware platform. Instead, it's used in what's called a virtualizer mode. So the resources that are available to the guest VM are actually the exact hardware resources from the physical platform, except that this virtualizer intervenes during certain types of critical operations, certain specific instructions, or when it needs to pass control to the KVM module and the host OS. One example of that would be any aspect of I/O management, because all of the support for devices, the device drivers, are handled as part of the Linux operating system, the host OS. A huge benefit for KVM has been that it's able to really leverage all of the advances that are continuously being contributed to the large Linux open source community. Because of this, KVM can quickly adapt to new hardware features, new devices, new security bugs, or similar things. In fact, the KVM module was originally developed as a Linux module in order to allow regular use of Linux applications to take advantage of some of the virtualization-related hardware that started appearing in commodity platforms. All of a sudden, users realized that this can be useful to actually run guest operating systems and regular virtual machines. And so 3 months later, KVM was an actual virtualization solution that was part of the mainstream Linux kernel.